Charlie Simpson, born in 1985, is best known for being in the band Busted. Busted quickly rose to stardom in Europe and were financially and critically successful. Soon after, the band was shipped out to the US to crack the US market. With fame and money on their side, why would someone turn their back on this? To turn to this. Stay tuned, because we're taking a look at the Charlie Simpson and Busted story. When are they coming? Airplanes and enemies of our land. What are we facing? God knows only what is to come. Busted were formed in the early 2000s and were essentially a manufactured product, consisting of James Bourne, Matt Willis, and Charlie Simpson. They appeared on UK teen gossip magazine Smash Hits, where they were being labeled as the next big thing, before even releasing a song. This was the type of magazine that would big up the latest talent show contestants as being legit artists for the generation. Soon after, their first single, What I Go to School For, was released. The band would release their self-titled debut album in 2002, and three more singles, one of which was Year 3000. The album sold well, and was received well by critics of the time. The band would take home various awards, including one from the Disney Channel. The following year, their second album, A Present for Everyone, was released. The second album, while still very much pop music, had more edge in certain places. The standout track was Why, which is written by Charlie. The band struggled with their image. Despite wanting to be a punk rock band, they were always labeled and being shaped as a boy band, with the label controlling everything, from how much distortion is on their guitars to their live appearances. The most evident example of interference is the bizarre, incoherent song choices for B-sides on their biggest singles. Covers of trendy music like Black Eyed Peas clash with songs such as Hark, the Herald Angels Sing. The band would also release a German song track, Hurrah Hurrah, Die Schule brennt, for continental Europe. Artwork for their releases are always screaming out rad or extreme. You can almost smell the desperation of a label attempting to get their hands in every market possible. But what the label and suits didn't count on was Charlie being unhappy in a product and his desire to be an actual artist. By this point, Charlie had already started working privately on music for his new side band, Fightstar. Things would get worse for Charlie in the US. The band's attempt to break into the US was well documented in the TV series America or Busted, which was produced for MTV.
I want to put across the message that we don't want to be perceived out there the same way we perceived when we came out here. Just like the whole boy band thing, it really fucked me up.
Should be really good. We picked up a magazine or something in America and it said new band from Britain rather than new boy band from Britain.
From the beginning, the band made it clear they did not want to be viewed as a boy band. The US was a chance for them to start from scratch and make sure people understand that they write their own songs, play their own instruments. However, to the band's disgust, they would be promoted yet again to the teen audience as a boy band.
We just want to welcome you to Universal Records. We want to welcome you to the United States.
What we're trying to do is go to the teen magazine so every month these girls can fall in love with you so they can see that you are cute guys, they should love you, and they should buy your album.
All the girls can fall in love with you. All the girls can fall in love.
I was like, you can't be actually sitting there saying anything more wrong than I don't want to hear.
Their appearances would be for Nickelodeon Splat, teen magazines, and teen shows.
We really want to market the guys in the teen world. And then once we get closer to the album and we're launching the album, we're going to go for all the music press. Get you guys on a show called Splat on Nickelodeon.
Splats.
Yes, but it's not going to be a very cheesy kid.
I'm not really up for getting gunged on Nickelodeon.
The band's disapproval was met with vague threats of the failures of previous British pop acts in the US, such as Robbie Williams, formerly of Take That. The band's first live appearance in the US consisted of missing equipment, poor sound, and Charlie playing Fightstar riffs during the sound check.
Are we ready to have a sound change?
What is that? I don't use that ever. That's not the pedal I use.
I'm doing channel 3. You ready? Matt, are you ready?
I'm fucking the best. I'm almost like 20 miles to get bass in my ears, and I've still not got bass in my ears.
Are you saying one? Okay. I'm gonna go and give Dave a call. Adam, can you just take care of sound check?
Eventually, enough was enough. Charlie left Busted in late 2004. With Charlie leaving Busted, the band would split. James and Matt would pursue other music careers, before eventually forming Muck Busted, a Busted and McFly joint venture. Charlie would turn down joining this. He had his solo career and Fightstar. Charlie had done the unimaginable, a reverse sellout. He turned his back on the fame and perpetual money in order to create music he was truly passionate about. Just after the Busted breakup, Fightstar had a handful of appearances on UK mainstream TV. In the long run, the pop world didn't want them. And they probably didn't want the pop world. Fightstar were rock and metal. They continued to play shows and release records over the years. The reality of the situation is that rock and metal very rarely make money. Fightstar members all had day jobs, and eventually, it was time for Charlie to return to his day job, Busted. In November 2015, Busted announced they were back. Their third album, Night Driver, was promoted with a live appearance on the talent show, The X Factor. Said promoted track, On What You're On, is a lame, bland track copying the awful music of Maroon 5. One of the worst bands I've ever been unlucky enough to hear. Despite this, the rest of the album is very good. Deep cuts such as Without It really shine with an 80s AOR vibe. Coincidentally, it's Charlie's favorite track on the record. After this came Halfway There, the album Busted always wanted to make, a true pop-punk record. Did Charlie sell out by returning to Busted? I don't think so. Times have changed, and Charlie has recently picked up the 7-string guitar again to write some riffs. Fightstar are here to stay, even if they now call themselves a passion project.